Thank you for watching this episode of Inland Empire Alive. We really appreciate it. Now you can go over to the YouTube channel if you haven't already and hit subscribe on the IE Media Group YouTube channel. And while you're there, make sure you hit that notification bell. It's very important. Welcome back to Inland Empire Alive. We're going to rock out right now. We got Bill from Doctor Strange Records. Bill, there's so much to talk about right now in the music industry, the local music scene. But first off, Doctor Strange Records, what do you guys do there exactly?
What do we not do?
Exactly, right? I mean, you're wearing it, you're listening to things. I mean, like, there's all kinds of stuff going on.
Well, just real briefly, Doctor Strange started 30 years ago next month. And I started out in my apartment just in Altaloma.
Yeah.
As a mail order company. And then several years later, found a record store in old downtown Altaloma. It's the first post office. It's 112 years old, which is an old building for California for sure. It's a great building. It's in a residential mixed use area. So that's now home to Dr. Strange Records, which is a record store, clothing store. We sell a little bit of everything, but we specialize in rare out of print punk rock. But we have t-shirts, creepers, Dr. Martens, you know,
a
little bit of everything.
Right?
And the way it's decorated is basically like a museum. It's a lot of my old stuff from the early 80s. You know, I've been listening to punk since 79. So I have, and I keep everything. So a lot of cool posters are framed, and it's a lot of memorabilia.
Now, did you open Dr. Strange Records kind of with the rise of punk music? Like, did it kind of go hand in hand?
No. I always tell people that come in to the store, kids, you know, you have to do what you have a passion for.
Yeah.
So when I started it, I was still working at a pizza place and waiting tables and going to school at Mount Sac, you know, just kind of messing around. But doing the mail order, I started the mail order because I was already collecting records and I realized I could get rare records for a cheap price. So why not get two? One for me and one for my buddy.
Yeah.
And then why not get three? One for another guy that may want it. I could make a couple dollars. Basically, he's paying for my collection. He's paying for my record. And it just kind of slowly branched out to t-shirts. I started making catalogs, passing them out at gigs, people's cars, other record stores, placing ads in magazines, fanzines, which is a magazine for fans, punk stuff, and it just kind of did that. So punk is a roller coaster. It rises and falls. It's on a big rise right now. It'll fall again. It'll just keep going up and down. It's on a rise because of the political scene right now, because of Trump, because people are angry. As long as people are angry about the government, there's going to be punk.
So a wise man named Bill from Dr. Strange Records told me Southern California has a, as he described it, vibrant punk scene.
It does.
Here in the Inland Empire, here across Southern California, why do you think this is a hotbed for punk music?
It's a hotbed because there's so many people.
Yeah.
So many people breed so many bands. There's a lot of younger people. I mean, there's people of all ages, races. It's just such a good mix. And I'm biased, but as far as punk goes, Southern California has always been the best. Best music.
Where's the venues, Bill? Like, where do people go to watch this music in our area?
In our area?
Yeah.
Mostly backyard parties.
Yeah.
Mostly.
Yeah.
But there are places like throughout Riverside, anything. Pizza places have shows. Clubs have shows. They come and go.
Yeah.
The only stable places are still going to be in Orange County, in Hollywood, LA. There's still some of the high desert. But for the most part, right now in this area, since the death of the Showcase Theater, which was a really cool place in Corona, that was a very stable place, they left and no one has taken that place. But it's a lot of backyard parties. Every weekend, there's got to be at least five good shows going on.
And you know all the bands, right? All the local bands, like the punk bands out there trying to make a name for themselves.
Yeah. There's a good place in Pomona called Characters. Oh, there's the Glass House, the Fox Theater. So
there's places, right,
there
to find it. If you're a fan of punk music,
You know where it is.
You can find it. You mentioned records. Are records making a comeback? The
Big
vinyl,
time.
Right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Almost died a few years ago.
Yeah.
Because of technology. Vinyl almost died because of technology, meaning that, you know, working at the record store, I would see people come in, two or three people, kids or whatever, and they would pick up a CD And the friend said, oh, don't get it. I have it. I'll just burn you a copy. And back it goes.
Yes.
And that group was not into vinyl at the time because of technology. You couldn't download it.
Yes.
Now things have changed. CDs are on life support, and they are scheduled to be dead next year, which is fine. And because of turntables having the ability with a USB port,
yeah,
now you have a record, analog record, which sounds the best. You can download it into your computer from that onto your phone.
From a vinyl record.
Yeah, we sell those.
Download into a computer.
Yeah, and it just sounds better. So
holy
technology almost killed vinyl, and now it really has saved it.
Let me ask you this, because we were talking off the air that you had a huge vinyl collection, right? Mm-hmm. Back in the day, and you're like, oh my gosh, what am I going to do with this? I can't even give it away.
Yeah.
Do you think CDs would ever make a comeback? They're done.
No, I don't think. I mean, you know what? I don't know. Cassettes made a comeback.
Yeah.
I'm not. You never say never. Never say never.
Yeah.
But I would bet a lot of money CDs will not. And that's fine.
And you said it, like you just touched on it, it sounds better coming off vinyl, right?
Mm-hmm.
Why is that? I mean, I'm not a tech kind of music guy.
Either am I. But I asked a tech music guy.
Yeah.
There's a process when you record a record, you have to get it mastered. Okay, so one of the legends is John Golden. He's been doing it forever. He used to be a producer, did stuff like Heart, but went on to punk bands like Black Flag. Ask him one question, sit back for 2 hours. He will explain it to you in detail. And basically, vinyl sounds better because of the way sound travels.
Yeah.
He said, imagine a CD as a staircase with right angles. Imagine a record as a sound wave, and your ear picks that up. The stairs, you're going to hear the pingings and the highs.
It's more rigid, right? I mean,
the CD's more rigid. Vinyl, analog, is a true sound wave, and it just sounds better. And it really does.
Going back to your place, Dr. Strange, it sounds like it encompasses the whole punk culture, right?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we're talking about, you said, like, I mean, you're wearing some of it right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, we sell belts.
Belt, your shoes. I mean, you're all decked out here.
Yeah.
Of course, you got the whole music collection as well, right? Mm-hmm. So, I mean, is it kind of a place where, you know, because there is a punk scene, right? It's a place for people to go who enjoy the punk music, right?
It is a scene.
Yeah.
And that's also what I've always wanted. It's a place to hang out, because a lot of people, not just in the punk world, but in the world, have troubles. So a lot of times people come in because they need a pat on the back. I've seen a lot of people, kids and otherwise, that are down and they have their own stuff going on, and they basically need a, hey, everything's going to be okay. And they hang out, and that's totally fine. That's the way it should be, a safe haven for everyone of, you know, any type.
Yeah. Bill, where can people get more information on Dr. Strange, all the things that you guys offer, you sell, all that cool stuff?
I would suggest Instagram at Dr. Strange Records, or just drstrangerecords.com, rarepunk.com.
What, real quick, because we got to go, what's Live Strange?
Oh, Live Strange. Every Friday, 4 o'clock on Facebook and Instagram is Live Strange. I make an ass out of myself. I make your mom jokes. And it's basically QVC for punk rock. I hold up a record.
Like, this is on sale this week.
No, this is one of a kind.
Oh.
We have one of these records, super rare record. If you want it as a customer, you call dibs in the comment section. After the show, call the store. We ship it out.
Easy as that.
It really is as easy as that. You just have to be fast and get the record that you want every Friday at 4.
Friday at 4. Thank you, Bill.
Yeah, thanks,
appreciate
Pat.
It. All right, that's Bill from Dr. Strange Records, and we will be back on Inland Empire Alive. Thank you for watching this episode of Inland Empire Alive. We really appreciate it. Now you can go over to the YouTube channel if you haven't already and hit subscribe on the IE Media Group YouTube channel. And while you're there, make sure you hit that notification bell. It's very important.